prepare yourself!
I'm about to rocket some iron through your think block, stranger!
I do, so I humor him, and I'm nodding long, all wide-eyed, and he's ranting, and he starts going, Vietnam was a goddamn picnic. Y'all ever read anything about World War II? And by now, all these guys, right, all these guys in the bar, they're looking at us because the place is filled with Nam vets. And then he goes, we're no real evil in Vietnam. No Stalin, no Hitler, no monsters like in World War II. Then he goes to my friend, he goes, have you ever heard of Josef Mengele? And I know by now one of these guys getting ready to clock this hit.
Mengele.
You never heard of Josef Mengele? No? No? See, now that kind of fucking blows me, because you kids, you don't know anything about any history anymore. Josef Mengele was this guy, and they called him the Angel of Death, and they called
him... I remember.
Really? So you heard the Angel of Death?
Yeah, I've heard him.
Uh-huh, what you heard?
He was, a Nazi general?
No. See, that's what I'm saying, no. That's what I'm saying, you guys don't know anything about any of this stuff anymore, and that fucking blows me. No, he was a doctor. He was a Nazi surgeon. He was the royal who did all these sick old experimentations on the Jews. Kids, mostly, some of the worst shit you ever heard.
Like Schindler's List.
Oh my God, no, not like Schindler's List, no, it's...
Sorry.
It's all right, look, I'm just saying that the point of the story is that we were the monsters and he was talking to them. And I guess also nobody fucking reads anything anymore. You got a name? It doesn't have to be your real name or anything. I just gotta call you something.
It's Mark. It's Marco. Bill. Who took you?
He took me some poison dirt or something. I don't know. I was walking open work. It was 99. Just wake up here and the fuck he does. This fucking shit.
Calm down. He's out cold. He's out cold.
You have to kill him now. Kill him now.
What are the keys to this?
He has keys. Listen to me. You have to kill him
now.
No
one's killing no one, all right? I just need you to listen to me. Listen, I'm going to get in there. I'm going to get the keys, and I'm going to get somebody. Okay, so no matter what.
He's going to lock you up in here.
I'm coming back, okay?
He's going to lock you up, and he's going to do it to you.
Damn, I'm getting old. Age sneaks up on you, crosses wires in your sleep box. You see my cigs?
I grabbed them.
I was afraid we smoked them all. All right, let's load up.
You good to drive?
Nope. Around this hour, deputies around here all blackout drunk.
I can drive.
No way, Jose. I'm surprised you can even hold a lantern with that hand. We gotta get you to the hospital. We're gonna get you fixed up. I'm gonna talk to them too, and they won't charge you nothing.
You want me to warm up the truck?
I got a feeling you're fixing to hit me with whatever it is you're holding in your hand right there, and given I'm guessing what you saw, I wouldn't blame you, but whatever you're thinking this is, it ain't. Well, there's a rifle right inside, pluck you clear off the riser. Now, if I had something to hide, I would have grabbed it the moment I saw you missing, but I don't, so I didn't.
How long has she been in there?
Easy, Marco.
How long?
Easy. I'm not gonna lie to you, she's been in there a while.
Count.
She's been in maybe a number of months, like 10, 12, but you gotta let me tell you now.
You locked her up for
no,
a year?
No, see, there ain't no her.
You think I'm fucking stupid?
No, you and me, listen to me. We're the only people on this property.
Shut your fucking mouth.
Look, I bet you watch a lot of TV and you think you walked into some Hollywood deal, but you got one rock. And in your condition, you'd be lucky to best me. So I was you, I let me say my piece and then Babe Ruth if you don't like it. Come on.
Couple years back, I'm coming home from Pam's place. Man, I thought I'd see something out there in the desert shaking like crazy, like a shadow shiver. Now, why I've been going over to Pam's to begin with was because of some weird shit. It weren't my first time. I've been over at least 24 dozen times already trying to figure out the creepy shit. Hey, you don't want to know it. You might think you do, but you don't. This ain't no spooky fairy tale. This is real stuff. And when real stuff starts to look like goats chewing chunks of glass till the bellies are leaking, or a house cat clawing eyes out of sleeping heifers in the night, you don't unsee it and you don't unknow it. So, like I'm saying, I'm coming back from Pam's. It's gotta be about 3 o'clock in the morning, and I slam on my brakes because I think I see this thing shaking out in the moonlight, so I stop. This thing, it move away fast. Now, for 6 months, I've been betting it's all been some freak running around, trying to poison animals, you know, for some sick happiness, right? So I'm ready to end it, because that's what vets do. But this thing, it moved fast. And I'm starting to feel like I'm in a movie. I spin my wheel, I yank it off road, I'm chasing it. I'm expecting to see some Looney Tune messed out of his mind, but it ain't. And I see that it's like something I ain't never seen, but I seen its shape. It's sliding and moving up into this canyon where there's a ridge. And I follow because I know it don't go clear through. And there we are, little wild dead end, in the middle of this black chasm. And I think, why don't I put on my big beams and bam, what do we got? Yes, we got a woman.
bare ass naked, trying to climb up a sheer wall. I grab my trank gun, I keep for coyotes, I pop her one, I truck her back here, I tie her up, I put her in the shed, I wait for her to come to, which takes for a little while, because these are some beefy tranks. But then what happens? About 3 hours later, 6 a.m., I get a call from Pam. And all them animals back at her farm, they're just licking ass now like nothing ever happened. That farm, it's now like a fucking Disney movie.
I'm gonna admit that's a very interesting story. But you have a woman locked in a shed. Meth head pervert fuck, I don't give a shit. You have to give her to the police.
Give her to the police, he says. You think a jail cell can hold that thing? You seen that shed? That ain't a woman when you ain't looking. I mean, it's something else.
She said she was walking home from work. You shot her. She woke up here.
That's a good one. I mean, it's always making up stories. It's always trying to trick what you know. Okay? But the real story? That's worse. Hear me out. That woman, its name is Asmodeus. And it's a demon, Marco. It's the king of the nine hells.
That's some dumbass shit.
Fine. Right in there, it's a book of Tobit. It's a holy book. In town, there's a local. He's a preacher. He did all the research. It says right in there that Asmodeus was born from the union of a succubus and King David.
The fuck's a succubus? A
succubus is a pregnant demon. Now, unlike all the other normal demons, Asmodeus was a cannibal and went around eating up all these demons until it became this thing.
How many demons are there?
There's boatloads of them. There's fucking thousands.
How the fuck you know which one it is, crazy man?
No, I know. I know.
How?
Trust me. No, you gotta trust me.
What'd you lie about, Bill? Bill.
Right in here. About what kind of shit happens when one of them kinds of demons comes around.
The lie.
Everything I talk about, what happened in that farm is way worse. Way worse. I couldn't even report it. If I did, they'd start thinking that it was us.
You know you sound crazy. I know a demon when I see it, and that ain't demon.
Well, it fooled me too for a while. Asmodeus started out as the demon of lust, okay? So, you gonna make me choose between describing the things I actually saw that barn and getting hit with that fucking rock? I'm gonna take my chances that you're right-handed. It got in our minds, Marco. It got in my dreams, my thoughts, the vile things I wake up thinking. You want to call me crazy, fine, but you gonna call Pam crazy? From the moment I locked that son of a bitch up, no evil dreams, no weird shit.
Okay. Let's say for a sec that you really is for real. And demons really are real, then what then? You feed it? How many calories a day does a demon need?
That's good. That's good. Because now you're thinking. I mean, it's kind of like, I don't know, maybe it's kind of like it's a chia pet. You know? But I guess you gotta water a chia pet, so maybe in that respect, it's different from a chia pet. Well, you don't believe me? Stay as long as you like. But you asked me, and I'm telling you, that bastard don't eat a crumb.
I gotta be somewhere. This was the part of my story where I was supposed to rise out of the desert, make things right. I keep wondering if maybe I died back there and this is some hell I've been earning myself.
Buddy, I've been asking myself that same thing for a long time now. You know what I come to? I smile. Therefore, I am. I smile.
I'm gonna talk to it. I gotta be sure.
Okay, well then I think you ought to go talk to it some more. But keep in mind, it ain't a person looking back at you. And Marco, remember, it says whatever it has to.
You sit and watch?
No. I'm gonna be right here making two big ass drinks because we're gonna need them when you get back.
Tell you.
He told me what you are.
What I am? What do you mean?
How long have you been in here?
I don't know.
How long?
I don't know.
Why? Why?
Why are you doing this?
Answer.
I don't remember.
You don't remember. You're locked in a shed for years. You don't remember? All right. Good to know.
No way. Please. I don't remember.
Okay, well, I remember. I remember the time I found a dumbass locked in a shed to try to pull one over on me. Okay, I'm a lie detector. I see into you. The truth. Say it.
It's him.
Admit what you are.
He's sick.
The truth.
I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. He asked me and he paid me the first time he paid me. And he just kept pushing.
For what?
And more and more. And these things.
For what?
These things. These things with the animals. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Believe me, I didn't want to do it.
He said that you're a demon.
What?
He said that you're a demon of lust.
A demon? He said I'm the fucking demon? I'm the demon? I'm gonna fucking kill him. I'm gonna slit his lying fucking throat. Please, I didn't like it. You have to believe me, I didn't fucking like it. You don't believe him, right?
I don't believe him. I don't.
Okay, so you're gonna help me.
Okay. I need the keys to the truck.
He has the keys.
No, I checked. He does not have them.
The canteen.
The canteen.
Check the canteen strap.
Okay, I'll check the canteen.
Okay. You're not gonna leave without me, okay? Please.
No. I think I'm done with the rock.
You still want that drink?
I think I might need two.
Well, I didn't say it was gonna be easy. There's always some comfort, though. I gotta remind myself from time to time that the world's a little bit less ugly as long as we're standing guard.
Don't move.
No. No.
Listen
no.
up close and fucking good. You listen to me. Now, I happen to be in a bad situation myself, and as much as I would like to stick around this fucking nightmare, I gotta find someone, and I gotta do it now, because I owe him. Now, I'm gonna walk outside, I'm gonna drive away in that truck. As far as I know, none of this ever happened. I drive away, I forget the end. But Bill, you are also gonna forget. You're gonna forget you ever had a truck, you're gonna forget you ever saw me, and you're definitely gonna forget to report all that shit you just now forgot to the cops. You got me?
I got you.
Swear it on that book. Yeah, that one.
I swear on the book it's Hobbit that I never met you and I sold my truck for scrap 2 weeks ago.
You know what I think, Bill? I think you're the demon. If I wasn't in a bad spot, I think I'd chain you to the porch. Saw off your feet.
We gotta go. Come on. Come on. I'm very, very late. Come on. Come on. Oh, it's not one thing. It's another. It's only one thing.